5, 4, 3, 2, 1. According to the prosecution, 7 assailants came in a Maruti van and assaulted a college professor and chopped off his right palm when he was returning home. The alleged motive for attacking the professor was that he incorporated a question for the internal examination of BCom paper criticizing Prophet Muhammad and Islam. Respondent is a dental surgeon. The prosecution case is that the respondent gave medical aid to one of the wounded accused in pursuance of a previous plan that if and when any of the assailants got injured in the attack on the professor, then immediate medical treatment would be given by the respondent to the injured, and that the respondent stitched the back of an assailant, which is not the job of a dentist. It was further alleged that the respondent was a member of the Popular Front of India, a Muslim organization, and was head of its medical committee. The prosecution placed reliance on the proviso to section 43(d)(5) of the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act 1967, which states that the accused shall not be released on bail if the court, on a perusal of the case diary or the report under section 173 CRPC, is of the opinion that there are reasonable grounds for believing that the accusation against such person is prima facie true. The instant appeal is filed against the order of High Court granting bail to the respondent. Dismissing the appeal, the court held. In the instant case, this court is only considering the bail matter and not deciding whether the respondent is guilty or not. Evidence has yet to be led and the trial yet to commence. Hence, the prosecution is yet to establish by proof beyond reasonable doubt that the respondent was part of a conspiracy which led to the attack on the professor. The case against the respondent is very different from that against the alleged assailants. There is no allegation that the respondent was one of the assailants. There is no prima facie proof that the respondent was involved in the crime. Hence, the proviso to section 43(d)(5) of the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act 1967 has not been violated. The respondent, being a doctor, was under the Hippocratic Oath to attempt to heal a patient. Just as it is the duty of a lawyer to defend an accused, so also it is the duty of a doctor to heal. Even a dentist can apply stitches in an emergency. Prima facie, the only offense that can be leveled against the respondent is that under section 202 IPC, that is of omitting to give information of the crime to the police, and this offense has also to be proved beyond reasonable doubt. Section 202 is a bailable offense. As regards the allegation that the respondent belongs to the Popular Front of India, there is no evidence as yet to prove that the PFI is a terrorist organization, and hence the respondent cannot be penalized merely for belonging to the PFI. Moreover, even assuming that the PFI is an illegal organization, this court is yet to consider whether all members of the organization can be automatically held to be guilty. In deciding bail applications, an important factor which should certainly be taken into consideration by the court is the delay in concluding the trial. Often, the trial takes several years and if the accused is denied bail but is ultimately acquitted. Article 21 of the Constitution, which is the most basic of all the fundamental rights in our Constitution, would be violated. Of course, this is not the only factor, but it is certainly one of the important factors in deciding whether to grant bail. In the present case, the respondent has already spent 66 days in custody and there is no reason why he should be denied bail. The appellant has filed this appeal challenging the impugned order of the Kerala High Court dated 17th September 2010 granting bail to the respondent Dr. Raneef, who is a medical practitioner dentist in Ernakulam district in Kerala and is accused in crime number 704 of 2010 of P.S. Muvattupuzha for offences under various provisions of the IPC, the Explosive Substances Act and the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act. The facts of the case are that on 4-7-2010, soon after 8 a.m, seven assailants came in a Maruti van and assaulted Professor T.J. Jacob of Newman College and chopped off his right palm from the vicinity of his house when he was returning home after Sunday Mass. The role attributed to the respondent is that he treated injured assailants.